Long ago, Earth was strangely colored bright purple instead of the two colors we most associate with its appearance today, green and blue. This color appeared in our planet's ancient oceans during two separate periods, one between 3.5 and 2.4 billion years ago, and the other between 1.8 and 0.8 billion years ago. Since this vast length of time encompasses 46.2% of our planet's history, it means that Earth was dominated by a purple coloration for more than 2.5 times as long as its more familiar green coloration we know today. However, I want to note that these periods of purple coloration occurred for different reasons and as a result had different shades of purple, with the older period being colored by this shade and the younger period being colored by this shade. While this concept might sound initially outlandish or even like a piece of science fiction, we are not only almost certain this actually occurred, but it also helps explain why our planet's plants are so distinctively green today. The first episode of purple coloration can be owed to one of the first life forms which developed on the planet, a type of archaea which belonged to the plant microbiome and thrived in the absence or near complete absence of oxygen at the time. These became widespread in the ocean beginning around 3.5 billion years ago and utilized our primitive form of photosynthesis that does not generate oxygen in what is known as anoxygenic photosynthesis. Instead of using chlorophyll like modern plants, a purple pigment was used to convert light into chemical energy, most probably a compound known as retinol. The most commonly emitted visible wavelength of light our sun emits, which reaches Earth's surface, is green. Retinol thus absorbed green light the most successfully, while inefficiently absorbing only a minority of light on the lower and upper bands of the visible light spectrum. As a result, these colors at each end were most likely to reflect off of the absurdly high population of primitive life forms in the ancient oceans, causing them when combined to appear as purple. While these primitive organisms dominated the oceans, other life forms evolved to capture some of the other wavelengths of light which were not effectively absorbed. Eventually, oxygen-producing photosynthesis evolved using chlorophyll to effectively capture light at both ends of the visible spectrum, but not effectively capturing the color green. As a result, modern plants today still reflect green light, making them appear green as a side effect of their original evolution to capture the only remaining spectrum of light that was not being harnessed at the time for energy. Yet, why did the retinal-based lifeforms largely die out? The answer is that 2.4 billion years ago, an explosion in the population of cyanobacteria occurred, which released oxygen as a product of photosynthesis. This oxygen began building up in the atmosphere and the oceans, where it was highly lethal to the retinal-based organisms. This is known as the Great Oxygenation Event, which lasted from 2.4 to 1.8 billion years ago, depositing vast banded iron formations on the ocean floor. However, since large amounts of sulfur due to runoff from minerals on land were deposited in the oceans became unusually sulfur-rich. This sulfur allowed for sulfur bacteria to become fairly common in the oceans between 1.8 and 0.8 billion years ago, where this time these organisms effectively absorbed the ends of the visible spectrum along with yellow. What they did not effectively absorb via bacterial chlorophyll A and B linked photosynthesis was cyan and bright red light, which, when reflected, combined to form a different shade of the color purple. These creatures would largely die out after increasing levels of oxygen once again began entering the ocean, although today, such lifeforms can be found at select locations around the world, such as Two Horsemen Lake and Canada's Yukon territory. These isolated examples can give you a glimpse of Earth's ocean coloration approximately 1 billion years ago.